welcome. Welcome. We're happy to be back. And what a great audience. What a great turnout. Thank you so much for being here, everybody.
Especially you.
So, I'm Russell Hale. I'm the first trumpet and artistic director of this group. We are the Houston Brass Quintet, and we do all kinds of different concerts and things around Houston, and education outreach is very important to us. So this morning, afternoon, whatever time it is, this Saturday we have a program of all opera music. So we call it the Night at the Opera. Yes, that's what we call it. Even though it's morning or afternoon or whatever. So
the next piece we're going to do is called Anvil Chorus, and we're going to need your help. So an anvil is like this big thing that they used to make swords with. It's really cool. Do you see one on stage today?
No.
So we're going to need you guys to be our anvil. So you're going to clap for us where the anvil would normally play in the opera. It's really cool. So first thing, I'm going to have you just listen to this little bit of music for a second. We start 3-4.
Thank you.
instruments in this group? You do? Okay. That's okay. You can raise your hand. That's good. All right. So what do Sarah and Russell play?
Trumpet.
Yeah, trumpet. Okay, so the trumpet is the highest pitched instrument in a brass quintet. And so because of that, it's the easiest one to hear when we do melodies and all the parts that you would kind of sing along to, right? So that's what we do. And if you stretch it out, remember these things? I think it's about 5 feet long. If you unraveled it like a paperclip, it would be about from here to Sarah. All right. Now the next highest instrument is the French horn. Aaron, tell us about the French horn.
So I play a lot of upbeats. That's not it. No. It's a pretty versatile instrument. We play really low, really high, kind of do it all, kind of bridge the gap between the trombone and the trumpet. And if I unraveled mine, it'd be about 18 and a half feet.
Yeah, so that's like from Aaron to me, something like that. So that's a lot longer than the trumpet. So he can play a lot lower notes than us because his instrument is longer. Right? He can also play pretty high too, so he kind of has us beat on range.
Yeah, just a little.
But why do you stick your hand in? Does anybody notice he puts his hand in his belt when he plays? Why do you do that?
Makes a pretty drastic sound difference. Kind of raw sound, and they want us to sound a little nicer instead of out in the field.
Pretty big difference, right? Yeah. All right. What is that?
Trombone!
So, you guys know what makes the trombone special, right? I mean, I'm the only one who doesn't have to press any buttons when I play, and all I have to do is this. And the instrument, if you unravel it, would only be about 9 feet long, but I can make it longer when I play, and that makes the pitch lower. And that sounds like a...
Yeah, so there's this, that's the slide trombone, right? There's actually a valve trombone too, actually, but you don't really see that very often anymore. Because slide is what, you know, it's one of the coolest things. All right, what about Alan in the middle? What does he play?
That's right. So, let's see, if we unravel this thing, it would be about 22 feet long. So, like, you know, for me to rustle. Right here. So
that's this pretty thing, long.
Yeah. This thing, as you can see, it's all tightly wrapped in there, right? So this thing gets all the low notes, right? So they were saying that the trumpet is the easiest to hear. This one's the easiest to feel, right? Rattles the whole room. Right? You feel it right there.
Same composer as the last song.
Yeah, pretty cool.
Giuseppe Verdi.
Thank you.
Russell is going to be playing part of this aria, and Mr. Jim. So this is called O Mio Bambino. O Mio Bambino. A really, really pretty song. So hope you like it. It sounds kind of pretty, but jealous of somebody, and she actually wants to go and hurt them. So that's what's kind of funny about this next piece. So if you listen to it, it sounds so pretty, but if you know what's actually going on, it's not so pretty. The other cool thing about this piece, we're going to need Russell back. Okay, good.
Okay.
He's back. Woo! Good. I was worried about you, Russell. Yeah, is it okay that the first thing you use your trumpet? You see? Nice. Okay, so Russell is going to play the solo on this one, and he's going to get that tiny trumpet back out. It's called a piccolo trumpet. And are you playing in B-flat on this one, Russell?
Yeah, he didn't play this one.
No, that one's okay.
I might only play this one forever. He smelled a little. Smell a little weird.
So, Russell, maybe he put this in the laundry last night and it came out a little small. But what we figured out was kind of cool about it is it plays really high notes like you heard earlier. So he can really kind of sound like a soprano singer on this one.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I'm going to do my best to tame the noisy cricket. Okay. Maybe the most famous opera of all. sounds like it's really weird. It sounds like bizarre. You know?
Yeah.
It's very bizarre.
It's kind of bizarre. So here is a really neat piece called Habanera.
You'll probably recognize these two if you listen carefully. Okay?
Thank you.
why and how and stuff.
How can you remember all the songs?
How can we remember all the songs? We can't. We cannot. We cannot remember all the songs. Definitely not. We have devices that have music written on them. So, just like you read a book and you know how the story goes, we read the music. And it's a whole other language made of little black dots on paper and, or in this case, a screen. Now, that's a big preparation. Any other questions?
What's the oldest instrument of all four of these?
I mean,
the answer is yes, kind of.
The answer is yes. So we all have a common ancestor, which would be buzzing into an animal horn or a conch shell that's bored out and it makes a, you know, kind of sound. I feel like we would argue about this. You know, this is a dangerous thing. There have been metal trumpets that don't have valves. The valves weren't invented until like middle of the 1800s. But there were metal trumpets found in King Tut's tomb. So that's a long time ago.
But they were called tubas.
They were called tubas.
Is that true? No.
No. I would believe them. No, I think, yes, the answer is we all kind of have that old.
Wait, y'all all have lines.
What instrument did we start on?
No, I mean, like, did y'all start in high?
Sixth grade.
Yeah, sixth grade.
Fourth grade for me.
Fourth grade. Fifth grade.
Six, going up the line.
I win. I started in second grade. Yeah, so.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I started really, really young. But yeah. Any other questions? Yes, way in the back. Is the what Spanish-like or Mozart?
The wig.
The witch.
The wig. The wig. Oh, wig. We don't have any wigs. This is my real hair.
Yeah, you wear the wig.
He's already on.
You're on a whole nother level, my man. You're on a whole nother level. What else? You play the piano? Good. Good. The piano is very important. We all play a little bit of piano. We all play a little bit. We should all play more piano.
Yeah.
We all feel bad that we don't play more piano, but good. Keep playing piano, and if you want to play other instruments, the piano will help you. Question? Did you have a question? Come on.
Ask it.
Come on. Why is one a different color? What a great question.
Oh, because I'm special.
Because this is the trumpet for ladies. No, I'm just kidding. That's just a coincidence. See, because my
piccolo
is silver, right? So why is it a different color, sir?
So it's interesting because all of our instruments are brass. The only difference is either the lacquer or Aaron's. Aaron's doesn't have lacquer on it. That's why his looks a little bit older than maybe, you know, Jim's or Russell's.
But it's only 10 years old.
Wow.
It's 100.
That's cool. They have something called lacquer on theirs. Mine's just a silver. That's the only difference. I like it because I think it sounds a little brighter. That's why I'm not on.
So the actual material is the same?
It is.
On the inside. On the inside it is. So if we pull out these slides and you look at this kind of tarnished looking inside part of it, that is raw brass like what you see on Aaron's. Although it's actually, I think, a nickel.
It's like a mix.
But brass is an alloy and it's different. Yeah. But yeah, so the gold ones, other than Aaron's, are lacquered brass, yellow brass, probably. And then Sarah's is silver plated. So that's actually silver, like you have on your rings and jewelry and things and such. And it's just very polished up, so it's nice and shiny. So these get tarnished if you leave them out in the elements. They will get tarnished. Lacquer is nice because it is very durable, and you don't have to do quite as much upkeep. But they're both pretty easy. It's a good thing we don't play violin, because, you know, wood is much less strong than metal. Yes?
I have two questions.
Okay. Who are they for? Me?
Yes.
Oh. Okay. I might hand them off.
How long is the piccolo trumpet?
The piccolo trumpet is exactly half the length of this trumpet.
Okay.
So that's why it plays so much higher, so much easier. So it's half the length. What's the other question?
And how long do you practice each week?
Each week? Okay, good question. Because it is more important to practice over the course of the entire week than how much in a day, right?
Yeah.
So that's a really good, well-posed question. What about you? How much do you practice over the course of a week?
Like a part-time job. At least 15 hours teaching and
yeah. Yeah, I think for brass instruments, I mean, 2 hours a day, every day, you know, would be pretty solid. Now, Jim has a very important thing happening on Monday. He's going to audition for the Houston Symphony. And so we hope he does very well. I'm sure he will.
He's a good player. He's probably a lot more hours.
Yeah. So how many? If you look, because he looked at me like, two. I don't know about two a day. What do you think? What for trombone?
Well, first of all, it's easier to play trombone for a longer period of time than trumpet because it's a bigger mouthpiece and it doesn't hurt your lips as much. I think anybody would say if you have something important coming up, then you change your practicing to fit that. But it's also important, like anything, like any sort of muscular activity, to give yourself a rest. So I think, you know, all of us do take rest days and take care of your face.
Yes.
I'm afraid we're just about out of time. I wanted to say a couple quick thank yous. Thank you so much to Nancy for having us out today, for coordinating all this. We're just really grateful. I want to thank our audience. We're a young audience partner. We're an ensemble on their catalog, and just being able to come out here and represent them just means a whole lot to us. We've been with them for about our second year, so it's really great.
Can we do this quick?
Yeah.
Just a quick plug. If you are the school district, or if you have, or your class is looking for your teacher, your elementary school, whatever's looking for a program, they can always go to youngaudiences.org online. If you're with a PTO and you're interested in having a program come out, it's a really wonderful resource. Obviously, Houston Brass Quintet's on there, but there's a lot of other programs as well, and it's a really great resource. They vet the artists. You have to be good to be on their roster.
We had to fight tooth and nail to get on there.
Yes.
And it's really cool because I grew up, you know, I remember being in elementary school and YA brought out groups, or my school brought out groups to play for us in assemblies and things, and it was super, super cool. I remember really liking that. And so now to be able to wear the shirt and do this for you guys is like a very, very cool experience. But yeah, they have dance groups, they have visual art type programs. They have all different kinds of music groups, theater groups, opera singers, acting. Like, there's a lot of things, and it's all on their website. It's a very good website. It's a national organization, and it's a nonprofit. And Houston Brass Quintet is also a nonprofit. So if you'd like to make a donation, please do so.
Feel free to check out our website. We're premiering a concerto for quintet and orchestra in October, and we're really excited about that. We'll be back here starting doing our Christmas programs, and then in the spring we're doing a bluegrass collaboration where we're working with a bluegrass band and doing all original arrangements, so that'll be really fun. So thank you so much for coming. Feel free to come up and ask us questions. Thank you so much again, Nancy.
Let's do the last four bars, yeah?
Oh.
Toriel.